There's an ominous feel here at the moment. It's almost dead calm out of Cairns Esplanade, but somewhere out there lies the worst tropical cyclone this country is likely to experience. Cyclone Yasi will hit tonight around 10 p.m. It's a Category 5, packing winds of up to 295 kilometres an hour. It's pretty much deserted around the Esplanade here at the moment because everybody has heeded the warnings. They've gone to evacuation centres, some 30 of those, full to overflowing with about 9,500 people, as we discovered today. The winds picked up, just a taste of what's to come.
This impact is likely to be more life-threatening than any experienced during recent generations.
All day they've battered down and stocked up.
Just been preparing the windows, boarding them up, collecting some water in some canisters.
Streets are now empty. Anyone not out of harm's way or in an evacuation centre has nowhere else to go but the smallest room in their house. Airports are closed. Planes have been tied down.
You're not staying here?
No, we're leaving.
You're leaving?
Around 10,000 people are in 20 evacuation centres in the danger zone from Cairns to Townsville, and some are now full.
If it's full, we'll go somewhere else. If that's full, we might find a big tree and lie under that.
Overnight, 280 patients from Cairns hospitals were flown to safety. When the CBD floods, the hospitals will too. The army, charter planes, even the government jet took them to Brisbane.
This is unprecedented in Australia's history.
Cyclone Yasi is now approaching the coast as a Category 5 storm, the strongest, threatening winds of more than 300 kilometres an hour, worse than Larry, worse than Tracy. It's narrowed its focus. Forecasters have it within 30 kilometres between Innisfail and Cardwell. Up to 700 millimetres of rain will come in the next 36 hours. Then there's the storm surge.
6.5 to 7 metres above that normal highest tide. People need to understand that their lives and their property are in danger.
North Queenslanders have been through cyclones before.
This is a powerful natural force, but the courage of the people of far North Queensland is an even stronger force again.
And this time it seems the grimmest of predictions will come true.
That all too familiar cyclone warning siren can now be heard on the hour, every hour up here. And if Cyclone Yasi does hit with the intensity that it's expected to, we could see up to 200,000 people without power and without communications. But that could be the least of their troubles.
Well, let's go to the Weather Channel and Lee Brooks. And Lee, how is Yasi tracking right now?
Good evening, Sandra. At the moment, she's around 220 kilometres off the coast, moving at 34 kilometres an hour, which has her making landfall, that very destructive core making landfall at around 11 p.m. local time. So that's between Innisfail and Cardwell. At the moment, we're already seeing wind gusts in excess of 140 kilometres an hour through some of the Great Barrier Reef islands. Even Hamilton Island at the moment experiencing wind gusts of 117 kilometres an hour.